This is St. John chapter 14, verse 8. Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it sufficeth us. Yahushua said unto him, Have I been so long time with you, and yet hast thou not known me, Philip? He that hath seen me hath seen the Father. And how sayest thou then, Show us the Father? Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. Verily, verily I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Brach the Yahweh, Brach the Yahweh Shai, 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 Yahweh, Bashim Yahweh Shai, Bashim Lakok with Dash, Brachatham, to the sincere Akim out there that's preaching his word of sincerity and the truth, and double honors to the elder apostles of Great Millstone taught us this truth. And in today's lesson, I'm going to get into the great and mighty works of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai, the Son of the Heavenly Father, the first spirit created by the Father Yahweh, the only begotten Son, the greatest spirit ever to walk this earth, our Lord and our Savior, which is our Creator who created us through the orders of His Father Yahweh, because He was the first spirit created, and through Him He created all things, starting with the elect. So Yahweh Shai is to be praised because He's going to get glory on the earth just as He has received glory in the heavens. And when Yahweh Shai was on the earth 2,000 years ago, He was doing miracles, spectacular acts to glorify His Father in heaven, not to glory of His own self. The works that He did on the earth were to glorify His Father in heaven. So Yahweh Shai was on the earth doing miracles. Miracles were done in the ancient world, and miracles will be done in this present world. St. John chapter 14, verse 8. Philip said unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and it sufficeth us. Meaning Philip is asking Yahweh Shai, look, we've been with you all this time, but we want to know about your Father. Show us the Father. What does the Father look like? And it pleaseth us. It satisfieth us. Yahweh Shai said unto him, Have I been so long time with you, and yet thou hast not known me? So Yahweh Shai is saying, look, have I not been all this time with you, and you don't know me, Philip? It says, yet thou hast not known me, Philip? He that hath seen me have seen the Father. Meaning Yahweh Shai was the exact representation of the Heavenly Father on the earth. He was a mirror of His Father on the earth. That's why when you read Matthew's 6th chapter, Yahweh Shai said in a prayer, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So Yahweh Shai is a representation of Yahweh on the earth. Yahweh Shai is coming down in the third dimension to get His glory in this realm. And His Father has the glory in the fourth dimension. So Yahweh Shai looks just like His Father. He came with the word of His Father, the doctrine of His Father, Yahweh. St. John chapter 14, verse 9. Yahweh Shai said unto him, Have I been so long time with you, and yet thou hast not known me, Philip? He that hath seen me hath seen the Father. Meaning Yahweh Shai looks just like His Father when He walked the earth. The Father looks just like the Son, and the Son looks just like the Father. They're a splitting image. And how sayest thou then, show us the Father? Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The works that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. So when Yahushua was on the earth 2,000 years ago, he came to do the will of his Father, the works of his Father. So the miracles that are written in the scriptures were the works of the Father, so the Father can be glorified on the earth. So for people to say that miracles were not done on the earth, meaning to say that you're not giving glory to the Father. Believest thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me? The works that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. So believe him, Yahushua, that the Father is in him. It said, if not, believe Yahushua for the very work's sake, the miracles that were being done. Psalms 110 and 3, thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power. Miracles were done in the ancient world, and miracles will be done in the present world. Believest me that I am in the Father, and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. So we, being servants of Yahweh Bashimah Washai and believers of Yahweh Bashimah Washai, we believe these miracles. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. So the works that Yahushua did on the earth, we're going to do those works and greater, because where's Yahushua? He's on the right hand side of his Father. He's in the spiritual realm waiting to come down to get his glory on the earth. So the works that we read about in the scriptures, we're going to do those works and greater. It says, because Yahushua go unto his Father. St. John chapter 14, verse 13. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. So whatsoever we ask in the name of Yahushua, that will I do. That will Yahushua do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. So these works, these miracles, are coming to glorify Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, the only true power to exist, the true God of the universe, the true God, the creator of everything. St. John chapter 14, verse 14. If ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. If ye love me, keep my commandments. So whatever we ask in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, it will be done on the earth. Because power is coming. Spiritual power is the manipulation of the elements. And that's what Yahushua was doing 2,000 years ago. Miracles, manipulating the elements, casting out demons, walking on water, healing the sick, healing the blind. All types of miracles that are so great, no amount of books on the earth can contain the works that he did. This is St. John chapter 21, verse 25. And there are also many other things which Yahushua did, that which, if they should be written, every one, I suppose that even the world itself could not contain the books that should be written. So Yahushua did so many miracles when he was on the earth 2,000 years ago that no amount of books on the earth can contain the works that he did. He did great works. When the Heavenly Father sent his Son on the earth, he had access to what? Spiritual power, the highest level of faith. He was able to do miracles. And we're going to go through a few scriptures on some of the miracles that he did, the great works that he did when he was on the earth. And those same works, us being believers of Yahushua and followers and servants of Yahushua, we're going to get the access to be able to do them same works through faith. Matthew's chapter 14, verse 13. And when Yahushua heard of it, he departed thence by ship into a desert place apart. And when the people had heard thereof, they followed him on foot out of the cities. And Yahushua went forth and saw a great multitude and was moved with compassion towards them, and he healed their sick. And when it was evening, his disciples came unto him, saying, This is a desert place, and the time is now past. Send the multitude away, that they may go into the village and buy themselves victuals. So Yahweh Shai had a great following of people that followed him. And he said what? He healed their sick. He was preaching the words of his father and healing the sick, so the father can be glorified. It says in Matthew chapter 14, verse 16, But Yahweh Shai said unto them, They need not depart. Give ye them to eat. And they said unto him, We have here but 5 loaves and 2 fishes. He said, Bring them hither to me. And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the grass. And he took the 5 loaves and the 2 fishes, and looking up to heaven, he blessed and brake and gave the loaves to his disciples, and his disciples to the multitude. And they did all eat and were filled, and they took up of the fragments that remained 12 baskets full, and they that had eaten were about 5,000 men besides women and children. So Yahweh Shai did a great miracle. He took 2 fishes and 5 loaves of bread and duplicated the elements of the 2 fishes and the 5 loaves of bread through the power of his father Yahweh, and was able to feed 5,000 men besides women and children. Now, is that not a great miracle? Is that not something great? Yahweh Shai was a great and powerful and mighty man on the earth, the only begotten son. Matthew chapter 14, verse 22. And straightway, Yahweh Shai constrained his disciples to get into a ship and to go before him unto the other side, while he sent the multitudes away. And when he had sent the multitudes away, he went up into a mountain apart to pray. And when the evening was come, he was there alone. But the ship was now in the midst of the sea, tossed with waves, for the wind was contrary. And in the 4th watch of the night, Yahweh Shai went unto them walking on the sea. Another great miracle. Yahweh Shai was able, through the power of his father Yahweh, to walk on water, to manipulate the elements and walk on water. Matthew chapter 14, verse 26. And when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were troubled, saying, It is a spirit. And they cried out for fear. But straightway Yahweh Shai spake unto them, saying, Be of good cheer. It is I, be not afraid. And Peter answered him and said, Lord, if it be thou, bid me come unto thee on the water. And he said, Come. And when Peter was come down out of the ship, he walked on the water to go to Yahweh Shai. So Peter, having a faith, believed that he was going to go to Yahweh Shai. He was able to what? Walk on the water through the power of Yahweh. It says, But when he saw the winds boisterous, he was afraid and began to sink. He began to sink because doubt entered into his mind, which came from the spiritual demon Satan. And that's what the spiritual demon Satan is here to do, to break your faith, to say, oh, there was no miracles being done by the Lord. Miracles don't exist. That's from the spiritual demon Satan to break your faith. No, miracles do exist, and they're going to be shown on a way higher and greater level than they ever were. Matthew chapter 14, verse 30. But when he saw the wind boisterous, he was afraid and began to sink. He cried, saying, Lord, save me. And immediately Yahweh Shai stretched forth his hand and caught him. And he said unto him, O thou of little faith, wherefore didst thou doubt? Because it's all about faith. Spiritual power, miracles, it's all about the belief. You must believe. And we know that the belief is a gift. Faith is a gift from Yahweh Shai. So you must pray to Yahweh Shai to increase your faith. Matthew chapter 14, verse 32. And when they were coming to the ship, the wind ceased. Then they that were in the ship came and worshiped him, saying, Of truth, thou art the Son of the Most High. Of truth, you are the Son of Yahweh. Matthew chapter 8, verse 14. And when Yahweh Shai was coming to Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother laid and sick of a fever. And he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose and ministered unto them. He used the spiritual power to what? Heal Peter's wife's mother from the sick fever she had. What's that? Miracles, spiritual power. Mark chapter 8, verse 22. And he cometh to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him, and besought him to touch him. And he took the blind man by the hand, and led him out of the town. And when he had spit on his eyes, he put his hands upon him, and asked him if he saw aught. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking. And after that, he put his hands again upon his eyes and made him look up, and he was restored and saw every man clearly. Yahweh Shai was able to heal the blind. People that couldn't see were able to receive their sight back. This was a great man of high faith, doing the miracles of his father Yahweh on the earth. Acts chapter 1 verse 5. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? He said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit has come upon you. So Yahweh Shai is telling his disciples, you're going to receive power after the Ruach HaKodesh, which is the Holy Spirit, has come upon you. Now we know we've received the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, via the Word. St. John chapter 6, verse 63. It is the Spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. So the Spirit is the Word. The Holy Spirit works within the Word. So we've received the understanding of the Word. We have the Holy Spirit. So what the Most High is going to do is he's going to turn it up. We're going to have the Spirit on the highest level, which is the highest level of faith, which is what? Being able to do miracles, having spiritual power. Acts chapter 1 verse 8, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. Psalm chapter 110 and 3, thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power, in the beauties of the holiness, from the womb of the morning, thou hast the dew of thy youth. So Yahweh Shai said that we're going to do greater works than he did. So Psalms 110 and 3, thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power. When the miracles take place on the earth, everybody's going to become a believer. But by that time, it's going to be too late. That's why the grace period is now to repent and get right. Because Yahweh Shai is raising up many fishers. And after he raises up his fishers, he's going to raise up many hunters. So the time now is to repent and get right. St. John chapter 14 verse 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. So with that, I want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem Rakal Gadash, Shalom.